Good evening, everyone. I'm Keisha Adderley, and welcome to the Bahamas Tonight, the National Report. Topping the news tonight, the government has taken countermeasures to curb illegal landing among Haitian migrants amidst politically driven violence in the troubled state. Repatriations have been placed on hold for now, and officials are looking to tighten border controls in anticipation of an influx. Another round of protests have hit Haiti as political discord gives way to violence and Haitian President Jovenel Moïse rejects calls to step down. The frequency of boat landings on Bahamian shores of late, signs of the internal fallout, along with the government's decision to place repatriation on hold for now.
We're waiting and watching mode to see how things and if things can settle down so we can resume repatriations. In the interim, I can tell you that we are talking to some people on the ground in Haiti to see how quickly we can resume repatriation. The Defense Force and Security Services are on high alert. Of course, the United States Coast Guard is intimately involved with the Defense Force and police officers of the Bahamas through Operation Turks and Caicos, Bahamas Turks and Caicos, which is also involved in the fight against illegal migration.
Foreign Affairs Minister the Honorable Darren Henfield says he's in regular contact with Haitian officials and looks forward to CARICOM talks in St. Kitts next week to strategize solutions to the disharmony. Anticipating increased migration, a temporary detention center will be set up along the country's southern border in Inagua.
Yeah, we have established a temporary detention center in Maputan, Inagua, which will be replete with all of the necessary ministries and agencies to cause that center to function. We are hoping that we do not see an extraordinary increase in migration from Haiti, but with the level of unrest, we are uncertain at this time what might happen.
Keeping Haitian boat captains at bay has been a challenge. This year, more than 200 migrants have infiltrated the country's borders, gaining access through Exuma, New Providence, and Abaco, where a boat sank, killing 32 migrants. Minister Henfield says now the government is looking to formalize talks with the Turks and Caicos Islands into an agreement which will stop human smugglers in their tracks.
An ideal outcome would be for us to be able to arrange with them a comprehensive ship riders agreement that would be able to extend their reach from the Turks and Caicos, because they don't have they don't possess the type of platform to prosecute illegal migration further out at sea as we do in the Royal Bahamas Defense Force. And so it would be ideal if we're patrolling in that area that we can stop in the Turks and Caicos, pick up a police officer, a maritime police officer, put him in our vessel and be able to effect boardings in that quadrant, which would push us further to the southeast.
The Haitian embassy is closed for now amidst violence which has already claimed 7 lives.